Well, it's time to get a bite on the Texas bucket list, and this week we're in Houston to get a fun food fusion at Cowboys and Indians. In a town known for its cultural diversity, it's no wonder you'd find a restaurant like Cowboys and Indians. Of course, images of the Old West first come to mind when it comes to this place. But once you walk in, it all makes sense.
Did you have people stopping by going like, this is the wrong way to do things, or thinking it was the wrong thing?
You know, I expected a lot of that, but I honestly, like, you know, I think whenever they would come in the door to do that and they realized, oh, they're Indian. You know, it's kind of like, it wasn't so bad.
Imran Khan is the man who has brilliantly marketed this fusion food restaurant.
Classic Texan cuisine, authentic Indian cuisine, the Houston way.
First, I was like, I didn't understand it. And I'm like, and then you come in here and you're like, oh, okay. I get it.
I thought it was hilarious.
Just like any culture, keeping the clan close is crucial to Imran's family. That's why you'll find them all here.
My uncles work in the kitchen. My mom and my aunts created recipes, and we've added different folks to the family, and it's just great to be able to see all that.
What are your uncles' names?
Babur, Akbar, and Rehmat.
Okay. Those are some gotta know names.
Yeah, I know, right? Repeat those things three times fast.
Yeah, right?
Alongside Chef Jamil Bhutto, the family cooks up creative dishes that pay tribute to two cultures a world away.
We've put together a great, great menu setup that doesn't have too much Indian food and doesn't have too much Texan food, but it creates a unique concept.
Imran took me to the kitchen to meet his uncles, of course, and to cook up three unique dishes. The first, a traditional Indian dish known as beef nahari, which happens to be Chef Jamil's specialty.
His beef nahari, to me, was the best in Houston.
Cooked 7 to 8 hours, Chef Jamil starts out with a pot of sauteed onions and adds ginger and garlic.
It doesn't matter where you are around the world, garlic and onions are very popular in every dish.
Garlic and onions are, you know, what can you do without garlic and onions?
Then comes the Indian spices.
So, no telling what's in this. This could be just all mixed up.
Yeah. That basically says, you know, that's his secret recipes.
Yeah.
And he's not really sharing that, and he's putting it in here right now. That was the Indian spice mix right there.
Beef shank is then added.
That looks amazing.
It smells amazing already.
Yes.
It's barely even cooked and it smells amazing.
Turns out Chef Jamil isn't done with the seasoning yet, as he adds even more unique herbs and spices.
Spice.
Oh, beautiful.
So these are all the different spices that he's got.
Oh, man.
You can notice some of them, what we were talking about earlier. The star anise is in there. The cinnamon is in there. Coriander.
As the beef simmers, Uncle Akbar got started on the nachos, a fusion dish that's a lot like nachos, just made with naan bread instead of tortilla chips. It's layered with mozzarella cheese, chicken, and a house-made topping called the 65 sauce.
Think of it as like an Indian barbecue sauce.
Okay, interesting.
You know, that's pretty much what we use it as.
And finally, I get a unique take on chicken fried chicken, which is of course prepared the same way you'd find at any old cafe in the Lone Star State.
What'd you tell him? Hit it harder?
Huh?
Hit it harder.
There you go. There you go. Make it sound like you're doing. There you go. Okay.
Make it sound like you're working.
Yeah.
Come on, Uncle.
Nothing out of the ordinary here until it comes time to top it.
You can get it with the gravy, but you know.
I recognize that one.
You can get that anywhere.
What
but
is that?
Here, you can get it with butter chicken sauce.
Wow, butter chicken sauce.
And butter chicken sauce with the butter with the actual chicken fried chicken smoking. When you put that in there, you're gonna love it.
Nachos seems like the right place to start.
Well, the flavor on the nachos is outstanding. That 65 sauce really does blend some incredible flavors together. And I love the naan bread because it's not crunchy. It's just nice and soft.
I fell in love with them. I almost like them better.
The smokiness of that 65 sauce is on point. That's amazing.
I'm not sure if you had the chance to try the chicken fried chicken. Holy cow.
Now I'm ready for that.
Well, you gotta give the white gravy a shot.
Creamy and peppery. That's the way you like it.
From there, we'll go to the butter chicken sauce. Time to get crazy.
Woo!
That is a lot thicker than I thought. Oh, this is gonna take things to a new level.
It's just amazing with the flavors, you know, with a little hint of Indian in the gravy.
Now that is some fusion. Wow.
Yeah, so good, man.
That takes that chicken fried chicken to a whole new place. Other side of the world, technically.
And I think once you try it and you aren't so intimidated by it, you're hooked.
Dousing that chicken fried chicken into that butter chicken sauce makes it taste like chicken fried chicken with a side of tikka masala. And it's good.
And finally,
The beef
Nihari.
That is unique. Very unique flavor. That beef is where it's at. Tender. I don't even know why I needed a knife.
The different flavors, the different everything. It's just something absolutely brand new.
Like a beefy, brothy soup, but just with a little hint of something different in there. A little bit of spice there too. Fantastic. Well, if you're looking to travel the world and try a little Indian cuisine along with some Texas favorites, coming to Houston and having a bite at Cowboys and Indians is well worth a stop on the Texas bucket list.
If you haven't tried Indian food, then try it.
Expand your horizons.
If you love Indian food, you love, you know, Southwest food, this is the place to come. You're gonna just come back again and again and again.
That's the one thing I've always loved about Houston is whatever you're in the mood for, you can find it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I mean, we've got everything. And it's great because it's not too many cities can say that.